After extensive research, I have determined that there is a connection between Drake and the death of XXXTentacion.
Developing right now, a search for a killer in South Florida after an up-and-coming rapper is shot dead. 20-year-old XXXTentacion killed in an apparent robbery. Police say the artist, whose real name is Jose Onfroy, was leaving a Broward County motorcycle shop yesterday when he was shot by two men who ran up to his car. He was rushed to a hospital but did not make it. Onfroy's death comes just weeks after he earned his first number one album, which debuted March 31st.
Oh, Drake is the most suspicious person in the death of XXXTentacion. It don't get much more suspicious.
The beef between Drake and XXXTentacion will go down in history. In 2017, X started getting his blow up with his song Look At Me. And this caught Drake's attention, and he decided to drop his newest single, KMT. Love is just not in my
plans. Not even taking it. This pissed off X, because X's song was still bubbling in the underground.
What up, where's your boy Charles Brown back again talking facts? Hit that like button, hit the subscribe, hit the notification bell. Keep sending those cash apps to COBMG. I appreciate you, gang. Listen, I feel dirty after everything I'm reading and hearing and watching about this XXXTentacion murder. It has not gotten any clearer. Well, it has gotten clearer. We know who killed him. They're in prison. They most of them got life. Some of them are trying to appeal their life sentences and things of that nature. And I'm just going to be honest. I did not in any kind of way believe one of the members that yelled out Drake's, that kind of blamed Drake. He tried to put Drake's name in the situation. When these guys first were arrested, they started to play on the Drake. They tried to get Drake subpoenaed. And I thought it was a silly move to try to bring in a pop star for a murder. The rumors about Drake having XXXTentacion murdered were there from day one. But what I've learned with this hip-hop stuff, this internet stuff, a lot of stuff is deeper than it seems. And first and foremost, I personally used to dig XXXTentacion's music. I know that is like kind of crazy for me, a staunch hip hop backpack guy, but I thought a lot of his music was well made. I thought he was a complete artist. Now, was he out of control? And did he taunt a lot of guys and bring a lot of drama to himself? Yes, he did. I saw X go from one of these, almost a hoodlum, like almost one of these guys that just didn't have any media training, just reckless, wild. I watched his documentary. He was very, very, he was violent. I'm just going to be honest. He had a lot of issues, internal issues with his parents, a lot of internal issues with his upbringing, and he acted out, right? I'm just going to be honest with you. So I saw the recklessness of this kid. I saw him fighting with Migos, right? I saw him fighting with Drake online. I saw him literally work up situations into a frenzy that they didn't need to go to. So I'm not going to act like XXX was an angel. And that's why this gets that much deeper, why Drake could have had a hand in this situation. Let's just say that. I saw him trying to change. I saw him trying to be a better artist and human being. And yes, he did what he did. We're not going to act like he didn't. He did what he did to his girlfriend. I believe 80% of what she said he did. I'm just being honest, right? But he tried to make amends. I don't think he expected his life to be worth anything. And when he started to blow up, per se, he started to realize, I am worth something more than just this rapper kid that in and out of prison. Yada, yada. He was about to do some time for the stuff with his girlfriend, yada, yada. And we're not getting into all that, because I know these XXX fans, they just get nuts about that. We're not doing that. But what I do want to say is, he was on his way to being bigger than Drake. And at the time of his death, he was streaming, I believe, higher than Drake. After he passed, it was crazy, right? But I say all that to say, it seems ridiculous that a rapper like Drake would actually have his hands in a crime such as this. a heinous crime such as this until you start to peel back the layers. And you, it's not just one diss song. It's not two. It's a bunch of things that was said before, during, and after this kid was murdered that you start to think like, wait a minute, Drake low-key acting like, he acting like a damn drill rapper. He damn near pissing on the grave. Let's just be honest. The dude wasn't in the ground but like a day or two before he came out with a song dissing him. This is what drill rappers do. Let me read this and we're gonna have a conversation, because if you're like me, a conspiracy is usually some nut job saying something without facts. But I have an open mind and I've been watching and reading a lot of information, gang. And me knowing the kind of person Drake is, I can't put this past him. Let me just say that. I'm going to be honest. I don't put this, once you hear, and I'm not even going to talk about everything, but I'm going to just touch on the basics of what I have been delving into. Because I wasn't even going to do the story. I was like, this is a dude that, the dude is facing life. He's trying to figure any angle. Now you're going to throw Drake in there. It's goofy. But once I decided to, I said, I'm going to give it a few days and I'm going to look at it. Once I started seeing these things, which I already knew some of this, but I didn't know all of it. It's looking crazy, gang. Let me read this article and we're going to have a conversation. Drake named as a possible suspect in 2018 murder of rapper XXXTentacion. Rapper XXXTentacion lost his life at the tender age of 20 on June 18th, 2018. That was 6 years ago. He was fatally shot outside a motorcycle dealership in Deerfield Beach, Florida. I used to do stories on XX when he was still alive and when he was after he passed. I used to do a lot of commentary on him way back in the day. So it's old videos. I used to do news, women news and all that. So I was very familiar with XXX. And when he died, it was crazy, right? But let me keep it going. Now, more than 6 years after his passing, Dedrick Williams, one of the three men convicted for his killing, filed an appeal claiming the late artist's beef with Drake could suggest an alternative suspect. His attorney, Mauricio Padilla, discussed the appeal in an interview on Law and Crime Network, November 30th, 2024. During the discussion, Padilla pointed out in an Instagram post that an Instagram post by XXXTentacion shortly after, before his death, he had said, "If I am killed, it would be by Champagne Poppy, aka Drake." Quote, "Imagine the dead said prior to his death that if anybody kills me, it's Champagne Poppy." Padilla paraphrased the post. The statement seemingly suggested that Drake may have been involved in the shooting. XXXTentacion had a history of public feuds. He explained that Josiah Dwayne Onfroy, which is his real name, had a past of public feuds. His beefs were not limited to Drake, but included other rappers affiliated with the Canadian singer's OVO label. So yes, he was beefing with quite a few of Drake's compadres, all in Drake's name, because he believes Drake stole his song. We're going to get to that in a minute. The attorney noted that many of his clients' witnesses, including other rappers, could testify about the two men's heated exchanges. Yes, they did go back and forth on Twitter. There was a lot being said. There's way more than I'm willing to discuss that they were talking about, because they were going back and forth for years. So let me just say that. According to Padilla, DJ Academics cautioned Onfroy during a conversation in 2018 about his ongoing feud with Drake. Academics allegedly told Onfroy that while he wasn't a gangster, that he might provoke a dangerous reaction from Drake. Padilla suggested that this has provided a context to XXXTentacion's remarks about Drake and his now deleted Instagram post. XXXTentacion's mother was also aware of his feud with Drake. Drake was subpoenaed to testify in the case and was scheduled for a Zoom deposition in February last year, but failed to appear. So I'm going to break all that down for the people that don't have no clue what any of that means. Drake and XXX were beefing for years. Anybody that was into rap at that time, that was into like SoundCloud rappers, they knew about XXXTentacion. They knew about his song, and they knew that he accused Drake of taking the song. When he was in prison, when he went to jail for a little bit, his song had blew up. They was making SoundCloud songs, right? He had a SoundCloud song called Look At Me. The song blew up. Allegedly, Drake heard the song, and Drake saw his interview. One of XXXTentacion's first interviews blew him up. right? He blew up off the first interview. And Drake saw the interview. Drake allegedly got in touch with his DJ saying he wanted to work with him.
A DJ that I...
Who did?
Drake.
Okay.
Drake hit up a DJ that I fuck with. You feel me? And bruh told me, Drake, watch your interview. He said he fuck with you and he fuck with your partner Ski Mask. He's like, yo, he's saying he go call your manager within the next few days.
Okay.
So I'm amped up. Initially, he was supposed to contact one of my managers. So he doesn't do it. That same week, bro, I go on to, I can't go on to the obviously because I'm locked up.
Yeah.
I'm on the securest phone, you feel me?
So you in jail, he's supposed to contact your manager, and then what happened?
He dropped a fucking video of previewing that shit in Amsterdam.
And when dude was in prison, he got that message, so he was excited. Now, when he said he was still in prison, he didn't hear no more about it. All of a sudden, Drake came out with this song, I believe it's called E.T. or something, whatever it's called. And it has the same exact flow as his. It sounds very similar to his flow. We all have heard the accusations of Drake stealing flows and stealing songs and not paying anybody and not giving credit. It's been plenty. I mean, come on. There's a 17-minute video out there of all the songs that Drake is allegedly taking from, right or wrong. Some of them he took from. Some of them he just paid homage to. But there is a 17-minute video showing you exactly how and where and what song Drake took from and why he's accused of being a biter and he's accused of stealing people's whole swag, their whole aura, and their entire lyrics to some degrees, right? Even got sued and had to pay out for my guy. What's the guy up in the Midwest? He took the whole song, right? I can't remember. But he did lose that lawsuit. So, with that being said, this guy went absolutely... If you know anything about XXXTentacion, he goes nuts online. He had no filter. He was absolutely ridiculous. He started to disrespect Drake's mom. He had videos. He went live talking about Drake's mom.
Tell Drake mom I want some... Hey, tell Drake mom I want some tapioca pudding. Tell Drake mom I like my pudding tapioca. And I like my kneecaps like sandbags. Yo... Hey, y'all like pudding? I like pudding, bitch. I like my hoes when they like pudding. I like my hoes with pudding, man. I like my hoes with pudding. Are you cutting? Hey, yo, I'm not gonna lie. I love y'all. Hey, this is so fun. I just like, bro, it's like, it's so fun to talk and know I'm not gonna do shit. If like,
he also allegedly had a picture of a lookalike Drake with, I don't know if I could say on his face. I'm going to have to try to bleep that out. But he had I don't know what to say, but he had it on his face and he wanted academics to post it up. Academics say, listen, bro, I'm not posting that up. You're going to make this man mad. You're going to push him too far. He may be soft to you, but the guys around him is not soft. So here we go to where I feel like some of this stuff needs to be addressed. I feel like we've seen that Drake is extremely petty. We've seen that Drake himself has acknowledged he doesn't let things go. He's patient with his revenge. He does not, in any situation, forget what you've said and done. And he does not give you, there is no piecing it up. He's going to try to get you, right? So when this guy passed away, he was shot, like I said, coming out of a motorcycle dealership. A lot of people saying that the people in the dealership went live, showing that he was there, showing their location. And these guys saw actually the guys were supposedly already in the motorcycle shop. And they saw him with this Louis Vuitton bag, 50 grand of cash in there. And he went to the car. They allegedly followed him to the car, robbed him in the car at gunpoint. And they claimed that he tried to fight and they shot him. But it didn't look like he tried to fight. It looked like he was like, please, yo. And they just start shooting him and took the Louis Vuitton bag for 50 grand. Now, I get it. If you're a robber, you don't want no problem. You don't want no hassle. I don't know many robbers that's going to just shoot first and take the bag. It just kind of crazy to me. Right? I don't know. There's going to have to be a struggle. There's going to have to be a fight. The robber don't want to sit there and fist fight with you. He on a limited timetable. He's not going to fist fight with you. But if you got your hands in there like, please don't, the robber nine times out of ten is not going to shoot. Now, With that being said, there is so much to this story where you start to think like Drake may have been a little bit involved. I'm just being honest. I didn't want to believe it. But then when you hear this guy went live talking about this man's mom's laughing, calling this guy everything in the book, going after this guy. Drake clearly knew the guy because when he started doing his charity event, Drake did the same thing, trying to mock him. That's how we got God's Plan and all this and that. That was mocking Triple X. Triple X's whole charity event, all this stuff that he was trying to do to clean up his image. Drake started to mock that, allegedly, right? So when this dude was gunned down and everyone is mourning and hip-hop trying to figure out who did it, and it didn't take long. These guys were online showing the money, and they only split up, I think it was five of them, and I think they five or six, and they got 10 grand a piece or less. It was a goofy thing, right? Because it didn't go anywhere. They got caught and really didn't get to spend the money. Like they spun it, but they really, you know what I'm saying? Like 10 grand, you could have just worked the job and got that. But Drake immediately comes with lyrics. Now, this is where it gets a little weird because you're a top 100, top 20 pop star. You're one of the biggest pop guys in the world. And you start coming with lyrics about a rapper that was just executed. So I'm going to read you some of these lyrics that make you think, yo, what the hell is this dude doing, bro? Right? They're using less lyrics than this to lock dudes up for 20 years. Dudes are getting more time for lyrics less offensive than this. So on the song called Daylight, I'm just going to give you pieces of this because I'm not reading the whole lyrics. But he goes, he shot him in daylight, broad daylight. I wasn't dead when they caught the body. TBS think I bought the body. Internet swear I bought the body. Take more than that to go pop somebody. Them niggas talk every day. So low key, I'm happy they got somebody. Right? You may say, Charles, he could be talking about anybody, but who's he talking about? You're a pop star. You don't catch bodies. What are you talking about? And then on I'm upset, he goes, SMS, triple X. That's the only time I shoot below the neck. Oh, that's the only time I shot below the neck. Why you keep on shooting if you know that nigga dead? That's the only kind of shit that gets you some respect, right? This dude was shot below the neck. He didn't get any headshots. They were all in his torso, right? So Drake is playing with this. He's playing with this. The dude is dead. His mom is grieving. He got a baby on the way. And now he's playing with this. In another part, he goes... In a rocket and that bitch ain't got no tags. Louis bags in exchange for body bags. They're alleging that he used to give out Louis bags for criminal activities, let's say. The dude, XXX, got robbed of his Louis bag with the 50 grand in it. They took the bag and they shot him and took the bag. So now he's playing with this murder, right? These dudes had real beef, but it was all internet beef. And then on a song called On BS, he said, if he held his tongue on that live, he'd be alive again. This is what Drake said in a song, After This Man Is Dead. That's three different, and I'm not even telling you all the verses. I'm going to play another clip of another part.
On Mob Ties, the rapper dedicates the song to how he's got ties with criminal members. I fuck with the mob and I got ties. Knock you off to pay their tithes. They want me gone but don't know why. It's too late for all the lovey-dovey shit. I'm your brother shit and all the other shit. It's too late for all that.
That's three right there. That right there is enough to me to say, yeah, this dude is bugging. Because at some point, you're trying to insinuate you had something to do. You're not only insinuating, you're telling us straight up, I had something to do with it for him talking crazy to me. So you're going to say, Charles, that's him trying to, he's selling wolf tickets. He's just trying to look big in these streets. But let's be honest. Most of the time, somebody trying to look big in these streets, they had something to do with it. How you going to look big with a crime that you had nothing to do with? And why do you want to? See, this is where the real separates from the fake. I would never, ever want to attach myself, whether I did it or not, to somebody's murder. I'm just being honest, gang. I would never write a rap about somebody's murder, whether I did it or not. That's where this game is so messed up. He wants that respect. Soon as most of these guys that get caught, they did something on Instagram. They put a live up. They made a murder trail to write to themselves. All of the guys that got arrested for this murder have a trail to themselves. Drake is insulated. Do you know what they said to the lawyer of this case when they try to bring Drake into the mix of a deposition and things like that? When the police first started investigating this case, Drake was a suspect. Do you know why they absolved Drake of being a suspect, allegedly? Because they checked his Instagram and they saw that he was not in Florida. That's the reason they eliminated Drake as a suspect. But Drake allegedly had two of his shooters in the town the same day that this happened. Right? Go look it up. Allegedly, two of Drake's quote-unquote shooters were there in that town the day that this guy passed away. Before that, one of his guys that he knows allegedly from Chicago, 600 Breezy, did it live where he was in Broward County looking for XXX. Where are you, X? Where are you? I don't see you. You ain't here. Because they was going back and forth. And they got real nasty with each other. But he never found him and nothing never happened. Now, think about this. You already had 600 Breezy going in and looking for him. Then you had Top 5 and whoever else down there looking for him. Why are they looking for him? They don't live there. So it's not plausible that they found him? It's not plausible that they paid these dudes to follow him? It's not plausible that Drake used some of these mob ties that he's claiming to have to whack this dude?
We put up pictures of Drake with Lil Wayne throwing up a Bloods gang sign and other evidence that Drake is out there flaunting gang ties. We put forth evidence of Hassan Ali, which is Top 5, out there openly claiming on social media and video that he's Drake's shooter. And part of the theory of defense is to show, listen, even though these people are entertainers, okay, there's a, you know, a gang related portion of it. There's a gang related side to it.
Because let's think about it. If I'm a dude that's so petty and I really, really care about my public image and you're calling my mom a hoe and you're disrespecting me, you're going to put out a picture with man juice on my face? And that's just the tip of the iceberg, what this dude was saying and doing to Drake. Allegedly, he had some kind of secret about Drake that he was going to expose. And they're thinking that it's worse than Adidon. And they're saying that Drake was going to do anything to stop this secret. And on top of that, the rumor mill, when you watch some of these documentaries, I'm just telling you, I went down a dark hole. I was like, bro, this is skeevy. That allegedly, when Drake says 50 grand on my head is disrespect, allegedly, XXX put a $50,000 hit on Drake.
Both X and Drake have been engaging in pettiness towards each other behind the scenes, and it got worse and worse. These petty actions might have prompted X to put 50K on Drake's head, which Drake took as disrespect and killed X for it. On I'm Upset, he mentions XXX right before he talked about doing a drive-by shooting.
Now, why would Drake say 50 grand on my head is disrespect if somebody didn't put 50 grand on his head? Let's be honest, 50 grand is not enough to get Drake hit. Let's just be honest. Because whoever does that really got, they probably got less than 24 hours before they caught. You're guaranteed to be caught. So 50 grand is really wild. But some dudes have done murders for less. But he says 50 grand on my head of disrespect. So these guys had an arm going back and forth. And I'm almost guaranteeing you that they were on the phone at some point with each other, probably talking mad shit to each other. Just be honest. Somebody gonna play the middleman. Yo, listen, Academics or somebody. Because Academics was big friends with XXX. Big friends. They had a falling out when X had died, but that was his man. So you heard me telling you earlier that he told him to chill out because this dude, he may not be, you think he's soft, but he got money that he can spread around and end this whole situation, right? Now, you're gonna ask yourself, Charles, why would Drake actually do this? Well, I am the biggest artist in the world. This dude is on his Instagram talking about my mom. He likes tapioca pudding and he wants my mom knees dirty and all this stuff like that. That's my mom, gang. That's my mom. Like, huh? That's my mom. He's talking crazy about my mom. He's talking about he got these secrets he's going to pull out and he tried to throw a $50,000 grant on my, he tried to throw a $50,000 hit on my head. Now imagine, he might do 100 grand next week. And then it might go 200 grand. This dude's money starting to get bigger. Just like Pac. When Pac said, you told me when I can't go to war till I get my money up. Well, I got my money up. And this dude wasn't letting off Drake. You got to think, Drake is not only petty, he's scary. I'm just being honest. So you put a petty dude that's really, really mad, that got these so-called shooters and got these so-called mob ties, and he's talking reckless on every record. Every time he's rap, he's talking reckless about this, that, and the third, about these mob ties. At some point, you can't have these mob ties, and this little kid in Florida is talking crazy about your moms and putting hits on your head. So imagine what's going through my head at night. I'm in my mansion, and I go online, and every time I go online, he's adding me. He's telling something. He's talking something more reckless. He's doing something ridiculous. And he did say it cooled off a little bit. Dude has, he said, when if I die, Champagne Poppy did it. But then he took that down, and he left him alone a little bit. But it wasn't cool behind the scenes. Right? You're like, just like I'm being patient, he being patient. Right? I don't know what this dude's cooking up, but if we can get him, you saw what happened with, let's just be honest. You saw what happened with Lil Durk. He didn't get him immediately. He didn't get him immediately. I think it took 2 years. Right? He never forgot. Never forgot. Tried to get him 2 years later. This stuff is real, gang. Now, you might say, how is it real when Drake is fake? It's not about being fake. It's about having the means to do it. Right? You would have never thought Lil Durk would have did all that because he's an international superstar. Guess what? He did it. Allegedly he did it. He's in prison right now for it. Right? So all I'm saying is this looking really crazy. That guy is really actively trying to get the judge to make Drake testify. Whether Drake did it or not is irrelevant. If he go and testify, they start asking him about these lyrics, he's going to have a real problem. He's going to have a real problem. So where we are with this point, I don't think that he's going to ever be in the slightest indicted. But do y'all remember when we thought Puffy was soft? Remember when we thought Puffy would have nothing to do with nothing? We always looked at him as corny, right? Diddy was corny. We overlooked every accusation about Diddy because we thought he was too corny to do anything. Come to find out, Diddy was a disaster. He was a menace. He was a devilish human being. They was telling us it took us 20 years for Diddy to get what's coming to him. And now here we are with Drake. The shine is starting to come off. People starting to look backwards at stuff from 4, 5, 6 years ago and say, maybe Drake did do that. Drake had a lot of people beat up. Which is provable. Drake beat a lot of people up. Drake had his ghostwriter beat up. We don't know what this man's capable of. We don't know what happened when this guy was in that motorcycle shop. We don't know who saw him for real, for real. We don't know. I'm just going to be honest. If I'm the robbers, I'm not just shooting you and then taking your bag. That's not how robberies work, gang. It's not how robberies work. They take your bag. They might slap you with the butt of the gun, something. They're not going to just pump you full of lead like that. It's more to the story. That's all I'm saying. Let me know what you think in the comments. I'll handle this to say, I am a very hard person to convince when it comes to somebody put a hit on somebody, but this ain't looking good. It just needs to be more answers. I'm going to catch y'all on the flip side. Peace.
Look, mission impossible to drop a few lines without dropping old times when Southern Hill was still a gold mine. When pistol grips was my shit and I sold mine. When Aliens was not a show and they told mine.
Elevate your mind with high quality THC infused products. BlackYeti.com. Black-Yeti.com.
CLB.